Okay. We're back at Tracy Edders with Stephen Hubbard. How are you doing, sir?
Pleasure meeting you.
In the middle of paradise.
Absolutely.
You can't do this with any other kind of boat, can you?
Absolutely not.
So just to give you the setting, the Palm Beach Boat Show is about a mile that way.
Yep.
And this is Rybovich Marina right here.
And we're in the middle of the bay.
We're in the middle of the bay on what? This is a man-made sandbar type thing.
It's the moon, isn't it?
It's the moon landing. In fact, with those traction pads, yeah, it sort of is. So you've probably got one of the most interesting jobs in the world.
Yes, absolutely.
How did you get that?
Just having a cup of coffee with friends.
Oh, so it wasn't in a bar?
It wasn't in a bar.
Okay.
It was in a show. And we were having a coffee with friends, and I was introduced to the owner of Iguana Yachts. I was in the marine industry, and we had a chat. And through that chat, he asked me, you know, can you help us get the boat in the United States? And I said, we can try.
Good Lord. So this company's been going for a while.
10 years now.
10 years?
10 years this
year. Made in?
Made in Normandy. Where else? Amphibious? Normandy. That's France.
So that, yeah, so you were saying this is designed to do exactly what we've done today.
Exactly. It's designed to safely park on a beach, get the guests in and out very easily, very comfortably. It's designed to be easy to operate. It's very friendly operations. And then it's designed to go, when you go home, you just park it in your backyard and you don't take care of it anymore, just like your car.
No bottom paint, no engine maintenance, no.
It's, no fenders,
it solves so
no lines. You know, no worrying, is it going to be windy and I'm going to have a problem about? Just make it easy and simple.
And so did you ever worry about getting beached? Or is it because it's like a tank, it will just go anywhere?
It's got the same capacity as a human being. So roughly, the ground pressure is the same as yours. If you go and put your foot there, it's going to go just as deep as that track. So if you can walk, it will be able to do it.
That's fantastic. So, okay, so how do you sell these things?
Just show them around.
Just play.
You know, just play, marketing. Have people experience it. You know, honestly, yeah. It's mainly have people experience it. You can talk about it, you can think about it, but if once you've experienced it, I don't know, what's your point of view? You've just experienced it. How do you feel about it? Is it different than you expected?
It's just so normal. As a boat, it's just so normal.
Exactly.
And then all of a sudden this happens and you're like, it's so much more.
Yeah, but what was your experience about coming out of the water? Did you feel that it was natural? Did you think it was hard? What was the feeling?
It was quite a rake.
I mean,
we came up and then came down, but it was smooth. It wasn't jerky. It wasn't violent. It was
safe.
Safe.
Safe and stable.
Yeah.
Exactly. That's exactly what it is.
So could you attach this technology to other styles of boats?
Yeah, we could.
So if you wanted to do a fishing boat?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, we have a fishing line of this boat.
Okay.
Yeah. So this model is really the tender side with a lot of seating. It's going to be very comfortable for guests. You can take them to the beach, but you can also take them to the restaurant in Monaco. It's still a very high-end, you know, boat, and it's very luxurious inside.
Uh-huh.
The fishing boat is more utilitarian. It's got fishing rods. It's got, you know, it's got all the stuff and rigging that goes on it. It's got Yeti coolers, absolutely. It's got a Yeti cooler on the under the console.
Oh, it does actually have a Yeti cooler.
It does.
Oh, well, there we are. It's our favorite boat.
and we have another model with a cabin inside. You can go inside. It's got a full windshield. It's got a very unique rooftop that goes up and down electrically. So you bring it up, it's like a hardtop. You bring it down, it seals up. If it rains, you're going to be completely sealed inside and just by a press of a button. So we have different models.
Good Lord. And so the tracks don't create too much drag?
Not at all. Actually, it was not expected, but it turned out to be an advantage because the ceilings on the sides bring a lot of air under the boat. So it's like a step hull. The air goes under,
wow.
But it's a step hull that doesn't have the chintz disadvantage of, you know, rigging into the, when you turn, it's still very stable when you turn. So what could have been a disadvantage turned out to be a great advantage.
Good Lord. So this for you, this started out as a conversation over coffee.
Exactly.
Were you already in the industry?
Yeah, I was already in the boating industry.
Doing
sales, import, export, US, Europe.
Oh, okay. So one of the problems we've been told about importing boats from Europe is import costs, transportation costs, doubling the cost of the boat.
That's not true. I mean, it depends. I mean, if you're taking in a $15,000 boat, yeah, of course, then the expense of transport and hauling and taxes. Well, I mean, taxes, you have to pay taxes anyway.
Yeah.
You know, it's not going to be more taxes if the boat is built here or if it's built outside. So that's not true. And at the end, if you have a high quality boat, you know, like we have, or a Riva, or, you know, higher quality boat that's more money, then the impact of transport is very low at the end.
True,
so
actually,
it's,
yeah.
So it's not a problem, and then you have to pay your taxes.
Yeah,
so,
everybody has to pay their taxes.
Absolutely.
So what were you doing before then?
You mean boats?
Yeah, and before you joined...
I was doing import-export for different brands. Yeah, and consultancy.
Oh, okay, so you were just bringing them in. You weren't not a specific company.
No, I worked for multiple companies.
Oh, okay. So that was your expertise?
Yes, exactly.
And it is quite a art, isn't it? I brought a few cars in, and the declarations and the requirements.
Yeah.
And all
if,
the coding.
If you know it well, it's pretty easy.
Okay.
If it's like everything, it's a jungle.
Yeah.
So when you know your jungle, you know you manage around it, it's not that hard because you have the knowledge. If you think, you know, oh, that's going to be easy, I'm going to do it like this, you know, it might take you a year.
Okay. So you got out of the office then, and now you've got the stuff that you know you're good at.
Yeah.
And then the stuff you can play with.
Exactly. And a beautiful product. Honestly, I fell in love with the product because it's so well made, it's so unique, it's so nice. The clients are so happy that, you know, I started as a consultant and then selling them more in the field. And it's really great because we have 100% satisfaction. People are so happy. It's not like, you know, I've been with other brands. Don't get me wrong, a lot of brands are great. But you always get into comparison, and then you go get people unhappy for, you know, details.
Yeah.
Where this boat is so well detailed that everybody's so happy.
I think that's, I mean, I don't know what it is, but when you walk onto something made right, you just know it is straight away. When you walk on something that's not quite right, you start looking
at details.
At detail and starting to work. And we got on, and it's just like, no, this is well done.
Exactly.
And there's no word for it. It's just a sensation you have.
Exactly.
Of something that's been done right.
And it's exactly the feeling I had. And a lot of our clients, most of our clients, they get their boat delivered and they go like, oh, it's way better than I expected. And when you do something like that, it's a satisfaction, you know, as an employee to say, well, you know, our clients are super happy each time and we're overwhelming their expectations. And that's
so much
really
better than getting the phone call going, so the boat's great, but we've got a couple of things.
Yeah, or
that's
usually not that nice. It's
usually,
when you have people unsatisfied, which happened to me in the past, they go crazy on the phone. Like, I've got my boat in the water, this wrong, come and take care of it, you know, which is a nightmare. You know, you want people to be happy. You know, boating is leisure. So it shouldn't be a constraint, it shouldn't be a problem. It should only be solutions.
It's amazing. We were interviewing quantum stabilizers who make the zero-speed stabilizer.
Yep.
And they were like, everything else can be wrong with the boat, but if the stabilization goes, it becomes unmanaged. It becomes unbearable for people.
Yeah.
And then we were speaking to a chef, and she said the same thing. If everything else can go wrong, but if the food's all right, then you can sort of overlook it. And it's all these little details that everyone has their part to play in.
Absolutely, yeah.
So, yeah.
To give a good feeling, you know, you need to be happy. It's leisure,
yeah. And you pay, do we do anything as vulgar as discuss price?
Yeah, they do.
No, I mean, what are we looking at here?
This boat, rigged as it is about $500,000.
Okay.
Which is quite reasonable if you consider the same size boat in the industry, and if you compare it to a custom tender, for example. It is a carbon fiber boat, by the way,
okay.
So it's a high performance boat. It's very durable, and it's got the landing gear on top of it. So, I mean, a boat like that in many brands would be the same price without the landing gear.
Yeah, without giving them any too much credit, who would you consider? Is it like the...
In the same field?
Yeah, is it like...
Well, if you look at Riva, for example, you know, any type of Riva, which is a... we're not Riva, and we're not in the same style, but if you look at Riva, it is a lot of money, and it's going to be roughly more money than this.
Yeah.
And it's a different usage, you know, it's different. You know, the Riva's got it on the lakes, and it's got a nice... you're part of a community when you have a Riva.
Yeah, I know the Pasco boys quite well in England.
Yeah, well, that Piscoy is going to be a lot more money than
Riva. Yeah. It's, yeah. Might be double, actually.
Yeah.
But it's the function and the quality and the cool factor of this just is.
It's a great boat.
Yeah.
It's an amazing boat.
So where's the weirdest place you've taken it?
That's a good question.
This one? No, this must be quite tame.
The weirdest thing I've done, which you're not supposed to do, is I transferred a boat from New Jersey to New York, and the boat was delayed, and I got to get in the water really late. And on the way, as I was going along Long Island, I needed fuel, and the fuel station was closed because it was too late. So I came into a marina, and I asked people on the boat, you know, where can I find fuel? And they go like, well, probably 50 miles. And I don't have 50 miles of range left. So I said, you know, well, okay, do you think I can leave the boat and go back tomorrow and wait for the fuel station to open? And they say, maybe we can help you with jerry cans. And they were really nice. So I said, oh yeah, that would be great if we can manage so I can continue. And then, so they said, you can put the boat there. And they said, can I put it at the boat ramp there? And they didn't know about what was able to go out of the water. They said, they would look at me and go like, what are you talking about? I say, well, can I just go at the boat ramp? Sure, you can go at the boat ramp. So I get out of the boat ramp, and they go like, oh, we didn't realize the boat could come out of the water. So anyways, the lady that was very nice there, her husband was working at the police department. So she said, oh, I'll call my husband, and we'll escort you to the gas station. So there we go, driving in the street with a police car in the front, one in the back, going to the to the petrol station and fueling up. I think that was the most awkward thing I've done with the boat.
Because tracks technically aren't allowed on the road, are they?
It's
Is
not
that the issue?
I think they are, but it's just not registered to be street legal.
Okay. Now, I think in England, if you have tracks, you're not allowed because it damages the tarmac.
No, that's not true.
No?
It damages less than a wheel.
Really? So that's just pure wife's tale that I've been
absolutely
taught. Right.
The ground pressure being lower, about 30 times lower than a tire on a car, makes it that it's got less impact on the tarmac than a car.
Wow, this is the future.
You're feeling it's digging in because the sand is really soft here. But if you put a car here, you'd never get it out.
Never get it out. Well, thank you for taking us on this little adventure.
My pleasure.
During the second day of this is during a boat show. This is during office hours.
Yes.
This is work.
This is work for you as well, by the way.
Oh yeah, this is.
It looks you have a hard work, don't you? You're staying on the beach on a Yeti cooler,
yeah,
having fun on a beautiful boat. You know, that's nice work.
It's a tough life.
Yeah, you have a hard life, don't you?
Pleasure to meet you, sir.
Pleasure to meet you as well.
Thank you.